Hello and welcome back to the Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival. It's been a journey over these last couple of weeks and we're so delighted that you've been able to celebrate the 30th anniversary of the Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival with us. We're very excited to continue to present this series of virtual concerts and interviews to celebrate Professor V. Lakshminarayana, who was a great music educator, musician, and a visionary. To begin today's concert, we have one of India's foremost singing divas, Usha Uthup.
Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain, to taste the sweet, I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains. I want one moment in time, when I'm more than I thought I could be, when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away, and the answers are all up to me. Give me one moment in time, when I'm racing with death. With destiny,
That was the singing diva Usha Uthup. Her energy and style is something we all cherish. Next, I'd like to present a very special message from our Indian ambassador to Madagascar, Shri Abayke. He's a poet, a songwriter, and we're glad to have his support for the Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival.
Namaskar. I'm delighted that this year, for the first time, a Malagasy musician, Rajery, is participating in the global Lakshminarayana Music Festival being organized in India by the violin maestro Dr. L Subramaniam. Artists from all across the world are participating in this global music festival, and Rajery, who plays the traditional music instrument of Madagascar, valiha, is participating. This time, it is for the first time that Indian and musicians and a Malagasy musician is coming together on a single platform. I wish that more and more such collaborations take place between India and Madagascar, and in the field of music. And I wish Maestro Dr. Subramaniam and Malagasy musician Rajery a great collaboration. Thank you.
Next, we're very proud to present some global music all the way from Madagascar. We have the instrumentalist Rajery playing the valiha.
Hello, hi, my name is Rajery. I'm a vali performer from Madagascar. This vali is a traditional instrument from my country, used will a traditional event and a costume. It has 18 strings, so it's a diatonic instrument. For example, now I would like to bring you and make it discover my country's through these songs. Please enjoy. Thank you.
What you just saw was the valiha played by instrumentalist Rajery all the way from Madagascar. The Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival has always been committed to presenting some of the best global music from around the world. To end today's special concert, I'd like to present a special conversation between the festival's founder, Dr. L Subramaniam, and singing diva Usha Uthup.
Namaste. Thank you very much for being part of Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival this year. And you sing so beautifully. And I heard the song so nicely sung with a lot of emotion and crystal clear voice and well in pitch. I have a few questions. Do you mind answering them, please?
Hi, Namaskar, Namaskaram, Sat Sri Akal, Salaam Alaikum. Yes, I'm absolutely ready for your questions.
When did you decide to become a singer?
When did I decide to become a professional singer? Actually, I never decided anything. I just happened to, it happened by mistake, or what a wonderful mistake it was, actually. Actually, it was in the year 1968-69, I think, when I really decided that this was going to happen or I would become a professional singer. I started off singing in the nightclub in 1969 professionally, but it was really not planned. Nothing was planned, actually. In fact, everything just happened just by chance. But as I always say now in retrospect, nothing happens by chance. Everything is planned. Everything is destined. And so it was destined for me that I would become a professional singer. Well, I went to a little place in Madras on Mount Road called Nine Gems, where my aunt, who was then the director of tourism over there, she decided to take us for a treat outside. And we went to this little place called Nine Gems. Now we call it Multiplex. In those days, it was just three theaters, Blue Diamond, Sapphire and Emerald. And in the basement of that was a place called Nine Gems. It was a little nightclub. They had a quartet playing over there. It was very, very nice. And my aunt just told me, because she knew that I was very fond of music and I was quite a musical person. And also, I was quite a clown. And I was ready for any kind of challenge. And she said, why don't you get up and sing? So I did. I actually got up and sang with the band. And the first song that I sang was, never know how much I love you. You never know how much I care. When you touch, you give me fever. You give him a fever, but so hard to bear. You give him a fever, yes. And after I finished singing that song, I realized that everybody liked it and they all started clapping. And when they clapped hands and asked me to sing some more, I sang a little bit more. And what do you know? After some time, I realized it was more than 45 minutes that I was singing and everybody really, really enjoyed it. And more than anything else, I loved it. I realized that very night that the intoxication of an applause is something you cannot, it's absolutely incomparable. You cannot compare it to anything else. And of course, as people would say now, I mean, the intoxication is much, much more than even three, four bottles of single malt or vodka or whatever you may want to call it, yes. But yeah, that's why I keep saying to everybody that I'm on a natural high, completely. So who was my inspiration? I come from a very musical family. That's right. My father and mother sang beautifully. I come from a family of six children. And at the eldest of the family was Indira and Uma. And they were the singing, swinging duo singers. Yeah, they used to sing in duo and they used to sing beautifully. They used to do harmony and they used to sing songs which were really, really of that time, you know, like the Andrew sisters. And so they were much my senior. Shall I say, I wasn't inspired by them, but I was in awe of them. I was really in awe of them. I thought they were the best two singers in the whole world. They were really fantastic, my two sisters.
Wow, so inspiring to hear this. It's almost like a Swayambhu coming destiny. You started singing. And also, I remember Sapphire Theatre, Blue Diamond, all those things. I studied in Madras and all fond memories come back to me. Who is your inspiration?
Radio and, of course, Harry Belafonte. Singularly, the biggest inspiration in my life.
Wow. Where did you get your major break, if I may ask you?
Actually, I don't know what you would mean by when did I get my major break in my life, I mean, in my career, because I was singing every day. I was doing nightclub shows and I was doing nightclubbing every day. And that was fantastic. It started in 1969. So I would say my major break came when I sang at Savera Hotel at the Golden Bowl. And I would also say that when I got an offer to sing in Bombay at the Ritz Hotel. That was a big break for me. But then the really big thing happened for me when I got the opportunity to come to Calcutta and sing in Calcutta at Trinkas and Park Street. That, I would say, was the first major breakthrough. But of course, at that time, there was no electronic media or anything like that. So whatever people know about me or knew about me was all by word of mouth, which is why everything was so... slow. It happened very slow, but sure. Yeah, it was slow, but sure. And I think that's why I'm still around after 51 years of singing, because it was slow. Otherwise, you know, it's I'm not saying that other people don't. I mean, you know, there are so many people who just do one video or one song, and they're one song wonders, and they've lasted probably. But 51 years without a godfather or a godmother in the industry, in the music industry, or in the film industry, doesn't happen. But I think the big thing really happened as far, if you're asking about the film, then I would say some of the big things that happened was Bombay Talkie, which had, it was James Ivory film, in which Shankar Jaikishan ji did the music. And I sang for that. Then I sang Bombay to Goa for R.D. Burman. Then, of course, and I acted with Amitabh Bachchan and Aruna Irani. And of course, the historic and iconic Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. That song, I Love You. I love you. Can't you see that I really do? Oh, please, please, please give me another chance. That was a big, big hit of mine, yeah. So it's been wonderful that, my career has really been checkered. But if you said which was the biggest break, I would say it was coming to Trinkas and in the concert circle. And I would say definitely after Bombay to Goa and Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, I think things really started looking up very differently and very wonderfully for me.
A beautiful span of your career. Fantastic. 51 years of solid singing, still going very, very solid. Starting in places like Leela Palace and Calcutta and other places. Then finally, you also sang in movies, Merchant Ivory films, and Hare Rama, Hare Krishna song. I remember it was so popular during that time. All my colleagues, we all listened to it. So beautiful. And you have sung that song so beautifully. Oh, fantastic. May I ask you, do you have any memorable concert or concerts you want to talk about?
When you say which is the most... memorable concert is very, very tough for me to say because I'm a live singer. And, for me, everything is on the stage. Everything is live. And I believe that I sing like there is no tomorrow. So memorable is difficult for me to pinpoint, but there are plenty of memorable shows that I've done. And I would say one of the memorable shows was when I sang for Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, who is the president of East Africa, Kenya, when he asked me to do a command performance for him. And it was a great opportunity to sing my song, Malaika, which I happened to record with the original singer who wanted me to do. So I was the first one to record from India. It was called Malaika, Nakupenda Malaika. Yes, that was quite memorable. What else was memorable? Of course, singing for Mother Teresa was really, really memorable. Of course, singing in front of Indira Gandhiji and, so many unbelievable things that have happened for me. And being able to do the peace song for APJ Kalam itself. I mean, I've done some good work actually in life. And some of the memorable things when I was able to collect more than 1 million rand for a particular song, in South Africa, in Durban City Hall. It was memorable for me. But really, I mean, almost every show is a memorable show for me, because I believe that a song is a song is a song, and the song is always bigger than the singer. So I'm always trying to attain a different kind of dimension to the same song that I may have sung so many million times before. So, yeah. So for me, it's very, very important. Every show, I sing it like my last and my first. So that's important for me. And I'm glad that you asked me that question, because there are so many things I could add to it. But yeah, maybe we'll do that in the next episode, if there is a next episode. It's been wonderful talking to you, actually.
Wow, I think I should have asked you, give me the list of your memorable concerts. You have so many fantastic, memorable concerts, and I know why also. You sang for the President of Kenya, sang for Mother Teresa, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, then our former President Abdul Kalam. Oh, these are all fantastic moments in anybody's career. And do you have any hobbies you can talk about?
I have plenty of hobbies, actually, but I don't get much time to pursue the hobbies. But I think one of my most amazing hobbies is stitching. I love sewing. I do a lot of sewing, and it's during the pandemic, it's like revisiting and reinventing myself and being able to, follow, or shall I say, pursue my hobbies. Reading to a great extent, but more so sewing. And I loved painting, but I didn't get a chance to do that for a long, long time. And I love ironing. I think it's like a therapy for me to be able to iron out clothes and, you know, things like that. Yeah, I think that would be one of my hobbies. And music is my biggest hobby, I think. What more can I say? Yeah, reading, stitching is the biggest one. Ironing, picking up from where I left off on many things like knitting and keeping home. And it's all part of my hobby. I love cooking, but I don't get a chance much to cook. But whenever I do get a chance to cook, I love cooking. It's not that I have to do it, but I love it. I love cooking.
Oh, what a list of hobbies you have. It's amazing for a professional singer who's so busy singing, having all these hobbies, ironing, painting, knitting, etc., etc. How do you find time for all these things? This is amazing. And one last question I wanted to ask you is, would you like to share your present projects or future project which you are working on right now? Because due to pandemic, everybody is in a way closed down. And do you want to share some of your projects you're working on?
Well, I have so many projects that I'm thinking about. I'm not like one of those singers who says, oh, there are plenty of things in the pipeline. There is nothing in the pipeline, but it's all in my mind. And one of the things that I'm working on is being able to, look out for, or shall I say, bring it all out, the really iconic Western songs, Western like Besame Mucho or Autumn Leaves or Kizas, the standards, you know, absolute standards, or Charade. There's so many songs. And when I get that out, and then because I am a nightclub singer, and playback just came to me secondary. And because I'm a nightclub singer, I knew all these Western songs. And I did a lot of shows and concerts where I was singing Hindi songs as well. And then I suddenly realized that, hey, this song sounds like that song. And so that is my project now, to put this song with that song. Like, for example, Besame, besame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Besame, besame mucho, que tengo miedo perderte otra vez. Ye sama, sama hai ye pyare ka. Yeah, songs like that. Okay, or siempre que te pregunto que cuando come donde, tú siempre me respondes. Quizás, 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 babuji dhire chalna. pyar me zara sambhalna. So I've got a project where I'm doing these two, okay? The originals along with the iconic, what shall I say, inspirational songs. And that's been really fantastic. We're already done with about 10. And we've got lots and lots more coming up. So we're looking forward to that.
It's fantastic to hear, you know, you're trying to do a project, taking similar songs and creating projects, and which will be also of great use for education, for the next generation to understand. And people like you can contribute a lot for not only, you know, people to follow how you sing, but also for music education, singing. And thanks a lot for being part of Lakshminarayana Global Music Festival this year. It made a big difference to me, and I'm really, really hope you do more and more great projects and share with the rest of the world. All the very best. God bless. Thanks a lot.
I hope you enjoyed today's performances and interview. As always, keep enjoying the music, and I hope you stay with us on our journey.
I'm very happy to say this particular episode is brought to you by Subramaniam Foundation in collaboration with Vishwakarma University in Pune.